If you've ever found yourself stuck riding public transport, there's one major downside: all those other people. In today's video, we're checking out some of the most innovative personal transports in production right now, from an e-scooter that fits in your backpack to the modular surf toy of the future. If it's an innovative transport built for one, we're going to walk you through it. Let's get to it. Italian EV manufacturer Sum Solutions is charging into the electric cargo bike market with their four-wheeled Sum X. The Sum X really consists of two sections. The front carbon fiber monocoque frame consists of the handlebars, seat, pedal relay, drivetrain, battery, and front wheels. Then there's the rear cargo platform, capable of carrying up to 660 pounds. This rear platform can be decoupled and swapped out with other beds of different sizes. Also, on board you'll find hydraulic disc brakes, LED head and tail lights, as well as front and rear coil suspension. Powering the Sum X is dual front wheel motors and an integrated lithium battery capable of a range of 35 miles. This, of course, is non-pedal assisted distance, and the full range can obviously extend far past that. The rear section is modular and hot swappable. Optional upgrades include covered canopies, front windshield and rooftop, temperature-controlled cargo boxes, solar systems, and additional child passenger seats. Their versatility has spawned many innovative offshoots, including the next e-bike we're looking at. Back in 2020, the European Institute of Innovation and Technology funded the development of a revolutionary vehicle for Horizon 2020, a project aimed at solving transport issues for those with disabilities. While we've come a long way in helping people with disabilities get around, loading and unloading wheelchairs on busy roads can not only cause congestion, but pose a safety risk to both the driver and passenger. The solution, named the Inclusive E-Bike, was engineered in partnership with Sum Solutions, creators of the Sum X we just covered. The result was a rickshaw-style e-bike with a rear-loading wheelchair-accessible ramp and winch system for added safety. Passengers can load in without ever leaving their chair, preserving their dignity, as well as getting moving a whole lot faster. The innovation in e-scooter design only gets better and better as the years go on. The Model 11 by Oakland-based electric mobility firm Unagi is a testament to that fact. Starting with a new space-age material known as long carbon composite, Unagi forged an ultralight frame that makes the Model 11 weigh in at a measly 32 pounds. They've then added a highly tuned elastomer-based suspension on both front and rear wheels, which also happened to carry the world's first hot-swappable, foam-filled tires. Propulsion comes courtesy of dual 500-watt motors that can take riders to a top speed of 20 miles per hour at a maximum incline of 15 degrees. A hot-swappable 9,700 milliamp-hour battery pack sits in the deck, and on a full charge, can take riders over a maximum range of 15.5 miles. However, what really stands out with the Model 11 is some of the cool integrated tech they've managed to pack into this little scooter. An onboard HD camera and intuitive AI crash assist system scan your surroundings and warn of potential hazards via an integrated audio system and the e-scooter's touchscreen display. Through a partnership with Google, it also features an advanced turn-by-turn audio navigation system optimized especially for scooter travel. Simply pair it with your smartphone, punch in your destination, and hear the directions in your headphones or through the scooter's speaker. Or if cruising with some tunes is your thing, you can play your favorite music via Bluetooth instead. Add in motion detection, GPS tracking, and anti-theft features, and you have an e-scooter engineered for the roads of tomorrow. We've all experienced that one guy on the bus or subway who has his bike or scooter with him. taking up the space of three people and knocks people over as he tries to get off. Next time you see him, you may want to recommend the Blizzwheel e-scooter. Developed by a Palo Alto-based EV firm of the same name, it has found rapid success as a project well-backed on Indiegogo. This is primarily due to its revolutionary compact design, which fits the e-scooter into a backpack, handbag, or even hidden in a desk drawer. In fact, it's so portable the Blizzwheel standard weighs just 8.8 pounds, making it one of the lightest scooters on the market. You'd probably expect the small size and lightweight would impact performance. Still, it has some surprising power packed inside. The segmented deck separates battery modules and motherboard, powering the 600-watt dual motors to a top speed of 15 miles per hour over a range of 15 miles as well. When not in use, the magnetic charging ports connect, eliminating the need for wires from the control board. This also allows the large battery module to recharge the smaller module when on standby. Recharging is via a mains DC charger, and a full charge will only take around 5 hours. At what point do strange new bicycle hybrids stop being a bicycle and start being something else altogether? The Verabike Extreme is the perfect example of the blurred lines in innovative engineering. It aims to give riders a full-body workout while still getting from point A to point B by blending the mechanics of rowing and cycling. Engineered in a similar vein to recumbent Delta-style tricycles, the Verabike was developed by German mechanical engineer Martin Kreis. Rather than just being propelled by hand or foot pedal, the arm and leg cranks can be configured in various ways, simulating either a full-range rowing motion or a combination of pedal rowing to increase power and work out specific muscle groups. Hardware-wise, the Verabike is constructed from a 70-20 aluminum alloy frame, comes equipped with mechanical disc brakes, a SRAM GX 10-speed drivetrain, and 3 20x2-inch wheels. There's no pedal or row assist, though. When it comes to getting where you're going, that's all on you. Electric is taking over, and it's not just the roads and outdoor trails which get to experience the rush of compact, rechargeable power. One such company taking the plunge is Jetworks, an innovative EV developer out of Germany who've released its product on Kickstarter for early funding. Releasing a product under the same name, the MoJet is the world's first modular electric watercraft. While we've started to see plenty of electric surfboards, paddle boats, hydrofoils, and underwater scooters, the MoJet is the first to combine all these possibilities into one. The MoJet starts as a polyethylene-bodied rear module that contains two removable 50-volt lithium-ion batteries, as well as a removable electric water jet drive unit. These batteries have a maximum runtime of 60 minutes on one 75-minute charge, but this can vary depending on what other models are attached and how hard you push the drive unit. The MoJet transforms into an electric surfboard when the surf module is connected. With one hand, riders hold onto a leash to stabilize themselves. With their free hand, they're able to control the amount of thrust via a wireless throttle. The bodyboard module allows riders to hold onto the two front handles and lie or kneel on the board. With the e-foil adapter module, you can transform your MoJet into a high-powered electric hydrofoil, gliding gracefully above the water's surface. With further modules to be released, including the dive, surf, air, and rescue models, there really is no limit to the versatility of the MoJet. Another climate often neglected by EV innovation is the sub-zero snow-covered mountains. The Moonbike is the green alternative to covering miles of powdered snow, a terrain traditionally dominated by snowmobiles and snowboards. Moonbike is a startup born in the Alpine village of Axony, a town sitting on the doorstep of the French Alps. The team there wanted to blur the lines between transport and recreation, while at the same time integrating the latest EV tech into their designs. The result was an e-snow trike that's 3 times lighter than a snowmobile and capable in up to 12 inches of powdered snow. While most EVs struggle in the cold, the heated battery box can operate in temperatures as low as minus 13 degrees Fahrenheit. The Moon Bike is fitted with a snowboard-like steerable ski on the front, while the rear has snowmobile-like rubber tread for increased traction. On board, the swappable 2.5 kilowatt-hour lithium battery powers the 3-kilowatt motor for a top speed of 26 miles per hour over a 2-hour running time. Moonbike doesn't quote a distance range, as alpine travel is so varied, especially with this model, capable of climbing hills up to 40 degrees. Instead, the battery can be fully recharged in 5.75 hours, or just 3 using the optional fast charger. When Torkel Homers, a mechanical engineer, described his latest electric modular vehicle, he said it was like riding a piece of art. It's a statement that really doesn't make sense until you look at Daimler's Research Lab's TD-MP1 prototype. With no bells and whistles, the TD-MP1 self-describes as pure transport and nothing else. The prototype is a noticeably 80s synthwave-inspired future tech design featuring blacked-out wheel rims, black-vented battery housing, orange saddle seat, and old-school minimalist LED readout for charge levels. While this prototype is still in the design stage and exact specs haven't been publicly released, Torkel has promised updates soon, including a whole suite of modular add-ons to make the TD-MP1 less artistic and more practical. If you enjoyed this video, you could help us out by hitting the like button, subscribe, and keep up to date on future posts.